the United States has grown and changed, so has its flag. Betsy Ross was a famous seamstress in the 1700s. Some people think that George Washington asked her to make the first flag. What do you think?
We hope you enjoyed learning more about the history of our nation's flag.
Every part of the flag is symbolic or stands for something about our United States.
When the United States was a new country, its flag had 13 stars and 13 stripes. The 13 stripes stand for the original 13 colonies that became the United States.
The stripes are red and white. Red stands for bravery and courage. White stands for purity or goodness.
The 13 stars stand for the first 13 states.
The background behind the stars is blue. The stars are in a circle to show that they're all equal.
Blue stands for justice. As our country grew, everyone realized that they could keep adding stripes and stars for each new flag.
So, the stripes mean that 13 represents original 13 colonies.
Star was added with each new state.
Since 1959, Hawaii and Alaska became states. The number of stars has stayed at 15.
Today, our flag has 13 stripes and 50 stars.
And blue. To our country's emblem will be true.
We learned that you were born in a one-room log Cabin in Kentucky in 1809.
We learned that when you were a boy, we learned that when you're a boy, you love reading so much that you even love when you love doing your chores on the farm.
That is true, and it was tricky to do.
We also learned that after trying many jobs,
like being a store owner,
a pilot, master, that you went to school to become a lawyer.
You were a smart and honest lawyer.
That is one of the reasons why they started calling you Honest Abe.
I like that name.
We learned that you were married to Mary Todd and you had four children.
Yes, and they were all boys.
We also learned that you were trustful, which is why I started putting important papers in your tall black hat.
We learned in November of 1860, you became the 16th President of the United States of America.
I'll never forget that name.
Abe, you're a great president, and we learned a lot. We honor you today for many reasons. We honor you for writing the Emancipation Proclamation that freed the slaves in 1861.
We honor you because you are a fair, kind, and honest man.
Well, thank you very much.
So, Abe, do you think that one of these fine first graders will become the President of the United States of America?
Well, I sure do, and I wonder what they would do as president.
If I were president, I would help people.
If I were president, I would be nice to people. If I were president, I would give people food.
If I were president, I would help clean up the town.
If I were president, I would clean the whole city.
If I were president, I would make things cheaper for the poor.
Thank you.
that there are symbols that represent our country. We are going to teach you five of these amazing symbols.
You can visit this famous bell in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
The bell no longer rings because it has a huge crack.
White House, where is the president? It represents leadership.
You can tour the White House if you visit Washington, D.C.
You can see Abraham Lincoln's bed.
Our nation's bird is the bald eagle. It represents strength and freedom.
You can see the bald eagle on the U.S. seal. The government uses the seal to mark important papers.
Did you know the bald eagle only lives in North America?
Mount Rushmore is a famous carving. It represents our nation's history.
You can visit Mount Rushmore in Black Hills, South Dakota.
Our first president, George Washington, helped plan the White House, but he never lived there.
It took 14 years and 400 men to carve the mountain.
Now that took some perseverance.
Uncle Sam's official camp to heal up his Nassau government. The most famous picture was used on a poster.
The poster was used to recruit people to join the army during...
Well, there you have it. We hope you learn a little more about our country.
America's greatest resource is its children. America's children are all different.
We have hope for peace.
Yeah.
treats and to see our learning.